Next, a parade was held in New York on Saturday to commemorate the first time Falun Gong practitioners peacefully appealed for their rights to practice outside the central headquarters of the Chinese communist regime 2 decades ago on April 25. Since then, Falun Gong adherents have endured 20 years of brutal persecution in China, including forced labour, torture, murder and live organ harvesting. NTD reporter Jeremy Sandberg was on location to bring you the story.
The unpleasant weather hasn't stopped these Falun Gong practitioners from coming out to participate in this parade and show their support for those practitioners in China still being persecuted today. I'm going to speak with some Falun Gong practitioners and find out why they practice and what this event means to them.
Practitioners in China appealed for the freedom to practice Falun Dafa in China after the government had started its crackdown. And so that appeal was one of the most peaceful appeals in China, but it was mischaracterized around the world. Today we're here to remind everyone of that peaceful appeal and that Falun Gong practitioners should have the right to practice. Unfortunately, today in China, they still don't.
This event is to share and let people know about Falun Dafa and how beautiful it is, how wonderful it is. But also there's a lot of misconception in the Chinese community because of the Chinese Communist Party has done a lot of propaganda, and we're here to clear up some of those misconceptions and let people know we're good people.
Reasons for practicing varied, but all agreed it was beneficial for both the mind and body.
When I did the exercises, that was when I knew it was something very special and profound, because one of the exercises requires that you hold your arms up like this for 7 minutes. And after that, I felt very energized and very good, even though it wasn't easy.
Those three little words, like truth, compassion, forbearance, they just like stood out to me. And I thought this has to be something incredibly good.
I think that I underwent a pretty big transformation when I started practicing.
I was looking for something peaceful that, like, you know, makes me grounded. It has brought a lot of, like, peace and love to my life.
20 years after Falun Gong practitioners first gathered at the Chinese Communist regime's central headquarters in Beijing to peacefully appeal for their right to practice, adherents of Falun Gong are gathered here today to call for an end to the ongoing persecution of practitioners in China. Persecuted for following a moral code of truthfulness, compassion, and forbearance. Jeremy Sandberg, NTD News.